Hi, let's take a very important question based on word problem, right? So the question says that in a class of 60 students, 43 passed in algebra, 15 passed in both algebra and geometry, all the students passed in at least one of the two subjects. We need to find how many students passed in geometry, how many students passed only in geometry, and how many students passed only in algebra. So again, we can solve this sum by two ways. Either we can solve by Venn diagram or we can solve by formula. Let's solve it with formula. Now the question says that in a class of 60 students, that means total there are 60 students in a class. 43 passed in algebra, 15 passed in both algebra and geometry. That means this question talks about two subjects, that is algebra and geometry. So we'll denote the number of students who passed in algebra with some letter, let's say it is A, and we'll represent the number of students passed in geometry with some letter, let's say it is B. So we start our sum with assumption, let A and B denote the set of students who passed in algebra and geometry respectively. Now let's see what is given to us. 43 passed in algebra. That means number of students who passed in algebra is 43. We can write in mathematical form, n of a is equals to 43. Further, it says that 15 passed in both algebra and geometry. Both means we are talking about intersection. So we write n of a intersection b is given as 15. Further, it says that in a class there are 60 students, that means total count is given, and when we say total, it is nothing but union. So n of a union b is also given as 60. First question says that we need to find how many students passed in geometry. Since we have denoted number of students passed in geometry with letter b, that means we need to find value of n of b. Three values are given to us and we need to find n of b. We can use a formula, right? So n of a union b is equal to n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. Let's substitute the values which are given to us. In place of n of a union b, we'll substitute 60 is equal to, in place of n of a, we'll substitute its value, that is 43. Plus n of b, we don't know, we'll keep that n of b as it is. Minus, in place of n of a intersection b, we'll substitute its value, which is 15. So let's do further calculation. 60 is equal to 43 and minus 15 gives us 28, plus n of b as it is. Now in order to get value of n of b, we'll have to shift this 28 on other side. The 28, when shifted to other side, it will become minus 28. So n of b is equal to 60 minus 28, and 60 minus 28 is equal to 32. That means number of students who passed in geometry is 32, right? So that completes our first sub-question. Second says that we need to find how many students passed only in geometry. Now if you observe, value of n of b is 32, that means number of students passed in geometry is 32, but out of this 32, 15 students are those students who passed in algebra also. That means if we want to find number of students passed only in geometry, we'll have to subtract this 15 from 32. That means it is n of b minus n of a intersection b, that is 32 minus 15, which is equal to 17. That means number of students who passed in geometry only is 17. Now that completes our second sub question. Now third sub question is, we have to find the number of students passed only in algebra, right? If you observe, number of students passed in algebra is 43, out of which in this 43, 15 students are those students who passed in geometry also. That means if we want to find number of students passed only in algebra, we'll have to remove this 15 from 43, that is n of a minus n of a intersection b, that is 43 minus 15, and 43 minus 15, when we subtract, we get value as 28. So that completes our third sum, and that completes our sum we say that number of students who passed only in algebra is 28.